Hello, everyone. My name is Don, the movie reviewer, and today we're going to be talking about The Beguiled.
Miss Martha! Miss Martha!
Is he dead?
No. Get him inside.
Quick!
You're a most unwelcome visitor, and we do not propose to entertain you.
You'll find them easily amused.
You won't be here long enough for that.
Can I get you anything?
Give me the key.
You know I'd get in trouble for that.
The Beguiled is about a runaway Union soldier who seeks refuge at an isolated school in 1984 during the Civil War. The story is about a man. This man is injured. These women find this man. They tend to his wounds. And yet, for some reason, each and every single female at this reclusive female school ends up being attracted to the character of Corporal McBurney, played by Colin Farrell. Yes, Colin Farrell is an extremely handsome man. But how is it that all of these women are so head over heels for this one guy who they really don't know anything about? Because to me, he just seems like the stereotypical version of a guy. The women at the school must have been super horny or something and had absolutely no contact whatsoever with the man for at least a couple years. The story present in this movie plays out with a simple format. I was bored during half of the runtime. The first act, which was the setup, is dull. The second act, which is the most interesting part of the movie, was engaging. The third act, which was the conclusion, was uneventful. I will say this. A majority of this movie's setup was boring. I understood what was being played out, and the build-up helped make other moments memorable. But while watching this, I just didn't care about the events that were unfolding because of the way this movie was executed. It all just felt tiresome. I wanted to fall asleep, but yet, I also wanted to stay awake because I wanted to see what the conclusion was going to be. Was it all worth it in the end? In a way, sorta. I did like certain parts of this movie, and I will say that certain parts wouldn't have worked if it hadn't been for the boring parts. Because this movie is like moving on a current, and then all of a sudden it's a tidal wave. And then, you know, it kind of just slowly drifts back onto a small current. Then here comes another tidal wave. Oh, it's interesting again. But then, you know, the good moments don't last very long. They're so far and few in between. And the boring moments just go on and on forever. And then it's just like back on a small current. And then by the end of it all just kind of fairy dust and drifts away and disappears and never returns. I knew where this movie was going. Now, was the ride exciting while getting there? No. Well, sort of. Because certain parts worked, and there were moments where I felt the emotional pain that certain characters were going through. However, it just took an extremely long time to get there, and so I grew bored and kind of restless, hoping that the ending would make everything worthwhile. Once the movie wrapped up, I felt indifferent about it because I understood certain characters' motivations while at the same time feeling confused about their decision making. The whole movie to me just felt like it went out on a whim trying to create something that was inspired and thought-provoking. But actually, it just ended up being tedious and uninspired. Colin Farrell, he's a sexy devil, very handsome man. His acting was good here. His character didn't really have a lot of depth to him. I kind of got the sense that there was something underneath the surface of his character. I mean, there was obviously something brewing, but as an audience member, I just didn't see his character having any real charm other than the usual, hey, baby, I love you. And it's like, dude, you just met this woman. You don't even know her. How can you love her? You know, you're just using her, obviously. So it's like there were moments in the movie where I did kind of feel bad for Colin Farrell's character. I did understand where he was coming from, but then when you think about it, he just really overreacted and brought everything that happened to him upon himself. Nicole Kidman. What can I say about Nicole Kidman? She's a phenomenal actor when she wants to be. And in this movie, she's okay. I didn't hate her character, didn't love her character. I just thought she was, man, she was fine given the material she had to work with. She just didn't do anything for me on an emotional level or anything like that. Kirsten Dunst's character, I felt, made some really stupid decisions that obviously made no sense. But her dealing with her character's self-effacing nature, I got a sense of where her heart was coming from emotionally. And so I kind of felt bad for her and I had sympathy for her. I think her character worked for me the most out of all the other female characters in this movie. Eli Fanning, she's your typical young girl who just has a rebellious side, and that's it. There wasn't any depth put into her character whatsoever, so to me, she was the most least interesting person in this movie. However, all of the young kids that were present here were great. I liked their sassy attitudes, and they were cute. But ultimately, they had no material to work with to push this movie forward. After the movie was over, I was left pondering in my seat, saying, did I like this movie or not? As I was still sitting in my seat while people were leaving the theater, I heard a lot of people saying, well, that movie was boring. Hey, that movie sucks. Evidently, I don't think the same. I like this movie for the most part, but as a whole, I just feel like it was dry, exhausting, mundane, and quite pointless. The characters in this movie constantly contradict themselves to the point of absurdity, to where I not only grew tired of them, I also became frustrated with their continuous stupid decision making. But then when I thought about it, I said to myself, hey, I was a young kid once, and I also made stupid mistakes that would have been obvious to the person watching me. We all sometimes make stupid, unreasonable decisions because sometimes we're just not aware of our minds, and so we get caught in a situation to where sometimes we just act without a conscience. With that being said, I can write off some of the things that I thought were irrational. I give Sofia Coppola's The Beguiled a B-. I give it a B- because I feel that the events depicted in here were interesting and I was emotionally invested in most of them. But the movie is just so tedious and some of the characters are just not interesting enough to hold your attention during its entire runtime. So it just sometimes feels boring, and the majority of the events that unfolded just felt like a standard, typical, melodramatic soap opera, and it just ultimately left me feeling empty. So as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. You had my love and I gave